Hey, so I guess in a way, what we've got here is because I'm including at the moment every single one of these pictures, what we've got here is a sort of portrait of the workings of my adolescent mind. And I've observed this in other kids discovering photography. Hello, go away. The processes of questioning and discovery and turning around an idea and trying it and a certain degree of, I guess, emulation and naivety and confidence, unbridled confidence, and ignorance and all those sort of things. Now, I've just, in terms of developing the workflow for this process, this project, I have, as I said in my previous video, just been trying, actually preparing the image a bit more in Lightroom first, and then editing it as a copy, or editing it in Photoshop from Lightroom. The one thing that I've noticed when I do it that way is that the image then has a, whoa, come on, mess that one up a bit. The image then has a second file that appears, which, it still satisfies the well, it ticks the box of keeping everything in one place and being non-destructive. Of course, I can open it as a smart object. Now, this is where I'm not. See, I learned photography before the digital workflow was as clear as it is now, and just the beginnings of digital cameras. So, yeah, what I'm trying to say is, when I try to open it as a smart object, of course, I have to rasterize the image before I can do this kind of repique, this kind of work with the heel tool. So, if you've got comments, I'm sure that I can actually learn a lot through this if there are people generous enough to point me in the right direction. Most of the time, I like learning through doing. But sometimes that kind of obstinacy can lead to ineffective practices. It's good to know when there's a more a less painful way of doing things. So, when there are a few more people watching, if now I was thinking this morning about a few things that this makes me think of, this project. Of course, it makes me think a little bit of, obviously influenced by the Contacts project, which was sur une idée originale de William Klein. Thank you, William. Family member? I don't know. But I'd love to meet you. I think you're brilliant. And I loved that series. I really did. And still do. More accessible than it's ever been, really, now. There is something of that, especially with this black screen focus on grainy images. Not that all the images in Contacts are grainy. And the quiet monologue of the author behind the images. And yes, I am the author of these images. Or I was. Am I still who I was then? Gosh, getting philosophical. The other thing that this made me think of a little bit is performance piece some years ago of Marina Abramovic. Was it Cleaning the Bones? Now I know that there's some, it may be considered indelicate referring or making even a comparison there, as the thematics of which she was speaking how can I say, very real. But I think there is a parallel here. And I respect my juvenile intentions and hopes and excitement and beauty. It was what it was, a slice of life, making memories. It is a significant part of who I am today. Who am I today? Ask yourself that. I do. So there may be also overtones in my talk of the practically the only YouTube channel I've steadfastly followed for some time. Should be seeing a bit more of her again. It's, I have to admit, I was doing it every day at my mother's place as I was helping her get to bed while I was looking after her in her final year or so of life, couple of years of life. I do yoga with Adrian. Oh, my steadfast assistant, do come in. You've had a haircut. I was just rattling on a bit too much. Do you want to help me? Fantastic. Let me get your pen ready. Everyone, please welcome my steadfast assistant. Steadfast assistant, please say hello to everyone.
Hello.
All right, just climbing into action stations here.
And what's this?
It's a bottle.
No, here.
Oh, no, that's just some skunk on the bottle. Now, you'll need to put your knees down there so that we can both fit. Yeah, good job. Okay, so we sort of take it one at a time again and just find our own little rhythm. Yeah, there's a good one.
Yeah.
Yep. Good job.
Yeah.
No, that's a...
Here?
Yeah, there. I think that's definitely a bit of... Let me do this one here. Hang on a second. Okay. Yep, good job. All right. Now I'll just move that up a bit so that we've got some fresh ones. So how are you feeling?
Yeah.
Good, thanks. Oh, hard drive's just waking up. There we go. Okay. So does it mean I should sing again now that you're here, Yasmin?
What?
Should I sing a song again once that you're here, the spot song?
What's that song?
Porta. Dot over here and a dot over there and a dot on your ear and a dot in your hair. There's a lot of little dots everywhere, everywhere. It's a dotty kind of day. Oh, that one I think is normal. Oh, good job. Okay. Let's have a look over here, shall we? There's a biggie there. Now, just be careful. See how there's numbers there? That's 150. Just make sure if sometimes when you do one of these, it messes up what's underneath and it looks a bit messy. Just tell me if that happens and then I can undo it. See that? That sort of messed that line up a little bit there. So I can just go Control Z. And undo it, and then maybe just to Very slight touch there instead. Just a dab. Wake up hard drive. Okay, now let's have a look. This is going pretty well. Let's move it down. There's a couple of little tiny dots here. There. Yeah, that's a good one. Yep, thank you.
I was going to get that one.
Great minds think alike, don't they, honey? Yeah, yes. Oh, just getting that one. You're a sweetie pie. Diddly dum dum diddle doo. Diddly mum mum diddle doo. That's the one I was thinking of. Yep, and I can see one up here. Oh, sorry, babe. Good job. Okay. It's very grainy. You getting it? Oh, you're in the groove. Good job. Okay. Let's funny. It's a dead pixel in the screen up there, I think. Oh no, it's the cursor. Let's have a little look. There's something here, right? I'll zoom it in a bit for you. Yeah. No, that's a good one there. That's, I think, what's up? No, that's a good one, darling. Leave that one. I think that's a little bit of stem. Well, there's actually, I think, a spider web that was on that leaf. Let's zoom out a bit now. Hand off for a sec. Isn't that beautiful? Reminds me of a series of photos ever since I saw that exhibition, Lee Friedland, I think it was.
What about this book?
And it was stems.
What about this?
No, that's all right. Stems of flowers in vases. It was really beautiful. Now those two, I think, are just, that's just light there and there. So there we go. So we'll see you later, everyone.